Blackstone Publishing presents The Magical Language of Others, a memoir by E.J. Coe. This book is read by E.J. Coe.
A note on translation. My mother opens her letters in Korean, Annyeong. This translates into hi or hello. I use both for the Korean greeting. Hi beams outward like the sun's rays. The tone transports energy without expecting reciprocity. One may absorb hi with a casual wave or respond with a smile. Hello boomerangs for a response. Over the phone, one says hello to hear a voice calling through silence. Hello is an alteration of hollow or holo from Old High German, hala or hola, used to hail a ferryman. Hello comes as a question. Are you there? Hello fetches me across an expanse of water. Eun Ji is the name she gave me. Eun as in mercy and kindness, closer to mercy than kindness. Eun falls between blessing and blessed. Ji lands at wisdom and knowing. Ji resides with judiciousness more than intelligence. Eun Ji does not echo willfulness or innocence. It resonates with softness and sensibility. Angela is my Catholic name after Saint Angela Medici, a holy messenger. My mother calls me Angela when she speaks formally. Angela is proper for its foreignness, postured for the public. Eun Ji belongs to her, Angela to everyone else. She calls my brother Changhyun, his Catholic name John, or your brother. For my father, your dad. For her, she is always mommy. Mommy addresses a child who remains one in her letters. This becomes clear when she switches to third person. When you feel a little better, if you want to talk to mommy again, call me. Her third person is, in part, her mothering. Since my Korean was limited when I was a child, she uses kitty diction. She stays mostly at a basic level. For advanced vocabulary, she transcribes the first definition in her English dictionary and notes it in parentheses in place of or next to the original vocabulary. Auntie must get jealous, envy, because I have my Eun Ji. Translating is problematic for her, but also a treat. The letters note at times the wrong English definition. In one, she means promise, and next to promise, she writes confirm, but misspells it as conform. She says, promise, conform, and say it to yourself. Her error becomes a delight that cuts tension or stalls grief. In another, she defines promotion as propaganda. She writes, I have to assert and promote myself. Propaganda. Her language slips out of a perfect transcription and gives relief with its obfuscation and humor. Words she writes in English or changes into Korean English are italicized in the book, such as last of my life and God is fair, you know. Japanese words she writes in Korean are romanized. 何が hoshii desu ka? Korean phrases are a favorite. Aja aja fighting. Not a signpost that signals transition between parts. This translates into let's go fight. The phrase uses the English fight or fighting. Aja aja is a sound of activity, quick-footed, rising from the gut. Together, they bolster fortitude. Readers may ask whether I wrote her back. Her letters are a one-way correspondence. The thought of writing her was unbearable. Korean was a language far from me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.